The story on this is Jack Nicklaus was playing in the British Open with a guy who grounded his club on a very windy day. The ball moved and he got a penalty. He looked at his caddy and said, "We're not grounding the club all day." He kept it up even when it wasn't blowing that hard. The next morning they came out after having a good round and his caddy said, "You hit it so well yesterday. Why don't you hit a few where you hover it up and see how that works?" 20 years later, he had never grounded it at all. It made him a great fairway bunker player, but it also was good for his extension to do that.
Oh!
Very nice.
Are you a person just like me that's always stuck in a bunker and can never get out? Well, today is the last day for that to happen because today we are with our coach, D1 coach of many, Hall of Fame coach, all of that. And he's gonna teach me all the different shots you need to shoot in a bunker and to just start getting your scores so low. So without further ado, without wasting time, let's get into it.
Have you ever heard of a fried egg?
A fried what?
A fried egg.
Yeah,
fried egg. In golf?
Oh, no, no, no. I was like, yeah, I had one earlier this morning.
Okay, all right. So a fried egg means the ball comes in and it's kind of embedded in its own pitch mark.
Okay.
Okay, so here's the way you have to play these. Okay, when you have a regular ball that's sitting on top of the sand, you enter the sand 3 inches behind it and the ball comes out on a cushion of sand. You don't actually hit the ball at all. If the ball was down here and you tried to do the same thing, you'd run the risk of hitting the ball. Mm-hmm. Okay, so it's still got to come out on a cushion of sand. So to be able to play a shot like this, you have to hit farther behind it and you have to go down more. It's not going to come up the same way. Mm-hmm. The key to this one is you have to leave the club in the sand. So I want you to watch this follow through. So I'm going to leave it down there, and very often sand will stay on the club face when you do it. Uh-huh. See, you don't stop, you get stopped by doing it. So if you've been following through on all your bunker shots and you try to do that on these, you'll hit the sand in the same place and it'll scull it into the face of the bunker.
Yeah.
And then if you try to dig, you might not know kind of how to get the feel for that. So you got to really be able to hit down very, very hard because you're going to be moving lots of sand. Now, a normal bunker shot can come out high and have lots of spin on it, which is a good thing.
Yeah.
Because there's so much sand intervening between the club and the ball here, there's no way you're going to get that kind of spin. So it's going to come out low and hot and running. When you hit a shot that's going to be here, you're far enough away, so that's not a terrible thing. Mm-hmm. But you got to get good at being able to pick it up fast and then leave it in the sand. So watch, I'm going to swing really hard, but I'm not going to follow through, and that's going to let that one come out.
Got it.
That feel that you're hitting down that hard and leaving all the energy, boom, into the sand and leaving it there, that's an acquired taste. Mm-hmm. So we're going to try that. So technically, if you get a buried lie and you can't find the ball, you get one dimple. So they used to have a rule that if you hit the wrong ball in the sand, you'd be penalized for hitting a wrong ball, but people were unearthing too much of the ball to identify it. So now you get one dimple. If you hit that and it's not your ball, you're allowed to restart the search and find it again. We're not going to be quite as open. We don't want it to bounce quite as much. So instead of playing all the way out to the left, we're going to aim just a few feet left of it. We're going to set up and we're going to try to really energize the sand, but you have to swing hard. But to swing hard and not to follow through, to leave it there like you're going to leave sand on it, that's a big thing. Okay, and I just want you to set up towards that little pile of sand. And we're going to be a little square. Don't touch the sand. That's a two-stroke penalty. Mm-hmm. Okay, so we're going to cock it up fast again. We're going to knife down into the sand, but watch. See how there's sand on the club face still. Mm-hmm. So to swing that hard, but to not follow through, to leave the energy in the sand, that's a little hard to do at first. What happens is either you swing soft and you leave the ball in the bunker,
yeah,
or you swing hard and you follow through. We don't want either one of those. Now see if you can swing hard and leave the club in the sand. That's the feel. Pretty good. Good. Okay, now stand into these two footprints. Okay, one here and one here. Okay, here we go.
Oh, there's the ball.
One dimple. That's all you get. That's all you get. Okay, now you're gonna leave it here. Knife it up, hit it down hard, but leave it in the sand. Keep it right there. Good luck. Here we go.
Oh,
not bad. You got it out.
I got it out.
Most people would look at that and say, no, that's impossible. I can't do it. But if you do it well, see, you hit kind of into the middle of the ball. It'll come out low and running, but it will be a real shot that you can plan for. Mm-hmm. That's an important thing to do. Next one is the biggest nightmare of all. Bunkers have steep banks on them, okay? So lots of times you'll be going for a pin that's over here and your ball won't get over the bunker and it'll hit in the face.
Yeah.
Most bunkers are manicured these days, so when it hits, it'll slide back down to the middle of the bunker as it should be. But you could get one that would stay right there. Mm. Oh boy, nice. Oh boy, that's not a good spot to be. Okay, so what you have to do, this is important, is you have to get over the ball. So watch, here's my chin way behind it. I'm gonna start walking up, start pushing down, start walking up, start pushing down. I gotta get to the point where I have my chin over where the ball is. That's the place. Now, when you have yourself over where the ball is, now you gotta get stretched out because you're gonna swing as hard as you can. So make sure that this foot, build a little station right here so you've got that pretty solid. Now, every other shot in the game, you have to decide how hard to hit it, but not this one. This is as hard as you can every time. If you wanted to go right here, you have to swing as hard as you can every time because all of the energy is gonna go into the sand. You're gonna be pretty square with it. You don't have to have it super open, but when you smash into the sand, it's gonna stop you dead cold and it's gonna pop up and go. Mm-hmm. If you were back here at all, it would come backwards. In a tournament, I saw a guy do this. He was 8 under par at the time, okay? He stayed back too far. The ball went straight up. It hit him for a 2-stroke penalty. It went into his footprint where he had to take an unplayable. He left that in the bunker. Then he sculled that over the green, chipped it on, and 3-putted for an 11.
Oh my God.
So, not a very good thing. But yeah, yeah. The key here is to be so close and hit a shot that would go 300 yards, and that's not gonna go 300 yards. So watch again, I'm gonna get all the way up here until I am looking straight down on this thing. Now I'm gonna get up to here. This one being bent is not good, but I have no other option, so I gotta really build a good brace right here. Now you gotta really get ready to go. This is not a little one. You gotta hit this hard. Here we go. And it's gonna come out every time. Mm. I don't care how bad it looks. Everybody's gonna say, oh, no, yeah. There are people who will take unplayables from there and say, no, I gotta put it somewhere else in the bunker and I'll take a penalty stroke. No, you can play this. But if you lean back and your chin's not over it, it is not going to work. Now, dangle the club from your chin, okay? Just with 2 fingers, okay? Take the other hand off, just 2 fingers. Now you're not over it, so walk until you're over it. Walk up, push down. Walk up, so you gotta push this down. You gotta find a spot for that left foot.
All right,
but get your chin, so you're looking down on it now, aren't you?
Yeah.
Okay, good. Now grab onto it. Don't touch the sand, it's a penalty. And you're gonna be right here. You're gonna be square. Good. Now, good mean. No f***ing smiling here, okay? Yeah. So we're gonna slam this in there.
Got it.
Okay. Now if you fall backwards a little after you hit, that's understandable, but I want you to stay in and you're gonna slam it in and you're gonna swing as hard as you can.
Okay.
I'm not kidding. Okay, so don't touch that. That was a penalty there. Hold it right there. Look at that yellow flag. Take a couple little practice backswings. You gotta be stable.
Oh man, okay.
So if you feel like you're not stable, you won't be able to swing hard, but I mean kill it. Here we go. Okay.
I got it out.
You got it out, okay.
Now, see, I just solidified
now,
this.
Now, yeah, exactly. Out. Now, had you not fallen back, it would have been a better shot.
Yeah.
But sometimes it's so steep you have no choice. But now that you know, now do one without a ball. Slam it in there and stay there. Stay there.
Got it.
Stay there. Slam it in. Okay, now that wasn't very hard. Okay, now try just one more. We're gonna get a ball in there this time. Okay, so here we go.
With my luck, I'll probably be in this position.
Okay. Okay, now here we go. That's coming out. Yeah. It doesn't seem like it can go up that fast. It can. Okay, we gotta walk back a little so you really stretch out. So walk back just a little with both feet. Okay, that's it. You're gonna swing hard at this. Come on. Here we go. Go hard.
Oh man.
Okay, so falling back's easy to do, isn't it?
Yeah, this
okay,
is
Okay, now if you say to me, but Mike, I'm not gonna be in this situation very much. I agree, I hope you're not.
Yeah.
But when you get into it, if you say, okay, I've got this, there's a way to play it,
yeah,
then you'll be calm and you'll go through your procedure and you'll learn from every situation you're in.
Yeah.
If you get a fried egg and you don't know that you gotta hit down and leave it in there, mm-hmm. and you try to follow through, you will not be successful.
Yeah.
If you're not far enough up the hill or you fall back too much, you will not be successful with this. But really, if you slam it in there, the whole cushion of sand is gonna come out and you're gonna be fine.
Got it.
So I want you to be versatile and be able to do all of that.
Gotcha.
Okay, very good. Now, the very last one is the fairway bunker. Okay, do you know what a fairway bunker is in relation to a greenside bunker?
It's probably like during in the fairway.
Okay, that's a good guess. I like that. So basically, a fairway bunker is one that is not greenside, so you're not going to play the normal shot where you hit the sand first. Mm. The ball wouldn't go far enough. So a fairway bunker shot technically is a bunker shot because it's in the bunker, but technically also it's not a bunker shot because you're going to hit the ball first.
Got it.
Okay, so it is exactly the same as every other shot you're ever going to hit. Now, the problem is that you're not allowed to touch the sand, so you have to hover it up. Now, on normal grass, you put the club on the ground against the ball, don't you? So you would think, well, I'd love to do that, but it's a penalty to do that. Mm. So what you have to do is you have to hover it up. Now, in this case, we're going to hover it up at the equator of the ball, no lower than that. Mm-hmm. So you would think, well, if I do that, I'm going to hit it right in the equator, I'm going to skull it.
Yeah.
No, you're not. When you swing hard, your arms are going to stretch out and do a better job. But here's something you have to do before you go in. Okay, back up just a little bit. You find something outside the bunker, like this little twig right here, and you take the club that you're going to hit for the shot. Now, because you're gonna be really stable with your body and not make as big and hard a swing, it's very clear that sometimes you take a little extra club because you know the ball's not gonna go that far. And if you have to get it up over a lip, that's the number one requirement.
Okay.
So if you're 5 iron distance away and you have an 8 iron that you have to get over the whip, you have to hit an 8 iron instead.
Yeah.
But if you have one that the whip is okay and you have 5 iron distance, you might hit a 4 iron because it wouldn't go quite as far.
Okay.
The other combination you might make is you might play it a little farther back to make sure you caught it on the way down, okay, rather than try to get under it. Remember, that's gonna make you do a bad job. But here's a skill you don't normally have. Okay, you set yourself up here where it's above it, and then you go down and you hit that first and you hit the ground afterwards. Mm. You gotta do that.
Okay.
If you ever warm up at a golf course, a very important thing to do is before you go out, is after you've hit all your shots, there's a lot of fairway bunkers out there, hit a few shots where you hover the club up an inch from the ground right at the equator of the ball and very close to it, then go down and hit the ball first and the ground second. And you need to do that before every single one.
Mm-hmm.
Interesting, there used to be a thing where if you grounded the club against the ball and then it moved, you were deemed to cause it to move. The story on this is Jack Nicklaus was playing in the British Open with a guy who grounded his club on a very windy day, the ball moved and he got a penalty. He looked at his caddy and said, "We're not grounding the club all day."
Yeah.
And so he kept it up even when it wasn't blowing that hard.
Yeah.
The next morning they came out after having a good round and his caddy said, "You hit it so well yesterday, why don't you hit a few where you hover it up and see how that works?"
Mm-hmm.
And then 20 years later, he had never grounded it at all. He kept it really just barely above the ground all the time, so it always stretch out and do a good job. It made him a great fairway bunker player, but it also was good for his extension to do that.
Mm-hmm.
So now that I've done that, I hovered it up and I hit the twig first. Now we're in here. We're gonna go with the little net that's over there. Now I want you to watch. I'm going to set up to this. Normal ball position would be a ball's width inside the left heel. I'm going to play it back just a touch to make sure I'm catching it a little bit first. So the handle would point maybe a little head just to make sure. But now here's the hard part. I'm going to hover it up here, but I want to hit ball first.
Mm.
Now, when you hit behind it, the sound it makes is F-U-M-P, thump.
Mm.
Okay? When you hit it ball first, it's a click. So you got to assume you're going to have the click. So you're gonna hit 100 greenside bunker shots for every one fairway bunker shot you're ever gonna hit.
Yeah.
You hit so many more. So if you're in a bunker and you're expecting thump and you hit sand first, then your 7 iron will go 4 yards out of the bunker. But if you go click, then you're gonna be fine. So you gotta be here, take a practice over the ball, make sure you're ready to be athletic and go, hover it up, and then go hard. So if you hit ball first, you can hit at the normal distance.
Okay.
No club that you'll ever hit is going to spin more out of any situation than a fairway bunker.
Okay.
So if you hit a particularly a lofted iron, you hit an 8 iron nice and solid and it hits a green, it's going to come peeling back. The crowd will go wild. Make sure you work on your crowd wave and your autograph signing, but really it's not you, it's just the quality of the contact. Now I need you to hit that thing first and then hit the ground second, but hit hard. Go ahead.
Yeah.
That was bad, wasn't it? Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, so if you hit behind it, what went wrong? Tell me.
I didn't rotate.
That's right. Okay, so you got to rotate more. Walk up to this one. Okay, good. Hover it up. Good. You're too close to the ball. Walk back a little bit. That's too far. Good. Right in there. Okay, now hit down hard, but keep turning. No ground, no good.
Yeah,
now, no see, good. If you don't do this before you get in the bunker, you got no chance.
Yeah, got
so
it.
So the first one you would have hit would have stayed in the bunker. The second would have sculled into the face, come back, hit you for a two-shot penalty, and you'd be lying five more, and you'd still be in the bunker. You're coming down hard, but you're continuing to turn. Here we go. Better, good. Okay, now, come on in here. Okay, look at that little net over there. Okay, so play it a tiny bit farther back than normal, but hover it up right there. Good, so get it down so it's right at the equator of the ball. Ooh, perfect, no lower than that. That's okay, right there. Now take a look. Now be athletic, but hit down and turn fast. Here we go.
Ooh.
Okay. Well, you did hit the ball first. That wasn't the best normal move through the shot, but you're very entertaining to teach. Yes, you are. Okay, one more time. You want to turn it over, not by closing it with your hands. That's a guy sitting in a chair. The continuing rotation makes the club close as long as your wrist is good. Remember we talked about that?
Yeah.
So if you get to the point where your hands are ahead like this, that one's open, that one's square, that one's closed. Mm-hmm. A guy who doesn't go, he's got to turn it over.
Got it.
So you don't want to slide. You want to turn right away. Okay,
gotcha.
So.
Is this one, I'm basically, what's this called?
This is a normal full shot.
Yeah.
This is nothing different. So you're just going to hit this as hard as you can, but finish over your head. Okay, so now.
But the club face is like this over
there? Well, no, you should never do that.
It's like this, right?
Yeah, all the time. Yes, that's what you want. Okay, now walk up to that one. Play it a touch back. So walk forward a little bit more. That's good. That's going to help. Okay, that's too low. More up the equator. Higher.
Higher?
Yes, right there. That's perfect. Now hit down while you turn. You can do it. But see, you hit behind that, didn't
you?
Yeah, yeah. See, so if you're trying to hit a shot 150 yards and you hit behind it, you hit it 22 yards, you don't like that very much.
Yeah,
but see, that you didn't finish your swing, so you hit that like a regular bunker shot, didn't you?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But like I'm telling you, you're going to have 100 regular bunker shots where you hear the thump for every one you hear the click.
Yeah.
So if you're used to hearing thump, then you're gonna hear thump on this and you're not gonna do it. So these require a little practice. Remember, you can practice these hitting normal shots, whether you're on grass or on a mat, by hovering it up at the equator and then hitting hard and making sure you hit ball first.
Gotcha.
That's the big thing. So do one more of those from over here. So set this up right here for me. See if you can do it. So I'm gonna put that right there. You're gonna aim in the same place, okay? But you're gonna hover it up at the equator. Now you need a practice swing, so step back a couple inches. Now make the divot happen past the ball. Good, excellent. Now hover it up and hit down the same way. Here we go, stay tall.
Oh.
Better, but you should follow through. Go all the way, very good.
So, oh, I hit it.
So that was pretty good. Both hands on. Okay, so don't stop. Go all the way around. Finish your swing. You get to go up to the tip of the toe. This is a full shot technique.
Oh, okay, got it. That's
not
what I was...
Yeah, it's not a short team technique.
Got it, okay.
Very good.
That makes sense.
Okay, so quick review, okay? Number one, before you get in the bunker, you want to hit a few normal ones to a place that's left.
Yeah.
And when you're hitting those solidly, because you're opening and closing back to square, you open one up, and then you open and close back to open, but you should have one that goes higher, shorter, and righter.
Okay.
If you're used to doing that, then you're ready to go into the bunker.
Mm-hmm.
Number two, when you're in a normal shot, you're gonna play at a balls width inside the left heel for everything, but when the club is open, that means you have to come around to here. So if you have the club face square to a place that's left, you'll know what a balls width inside the left heel looks like, and it will point there, but when you change the club face back the normal amount, the leading edge will point at the tip of your toe.
Mm-hmm.
You don't swing along the club face, you swing along your body, and when you do that, then you have a chance to get it out. Next is you have to put dents in. Remember, the skill here is having the descent happen while you're turning. It's all happening pretty fast. So if you try to get under it, you won't hit the sand at all. If you hit down and you don't turn, you'll hit way behind it.
Got it.
So because you're going pretty fast on a pretty short shot, you got to go down hard and you got to turn fast. So you got to get used to combining those together. If you do it with five balls in a row and you weave four of them in, you're having a bad day.
Yeah.
If you have five dents first and you're kind of getting better at where you're hitting the ground, and then the fifth one is a ball, you're going to progress much more quickly and you won't have that feeling that the bunker is an odious place to go.
Got it.
When you have a buried lie, you have to play it a little farther back and have it be a little squarer, but then you got to go down and you got to leave it in, make that club face be as vertical as you can be. In most good sand, you'll have sand on the face when you do it,
mm-hmm.
but it takes a little practice not to stop, but to get stopped by the amount of ground contact you have. When you have the one up in the face, you got to walk up the hill until your chin's over it. Then it won't have to be super open, but then you got to really take some practice wings. You got to stay extended because you're going to slam it in behind it.
Gotcha.
And if you can slam it in and weave it there, that's good. If you slam it in and fall back down the hill, that's not quite as good.
Got it.
And then finally, when you're playing a fairway bunker shot, it's not a bunker shot. It's really a regular shot. Mm-hmm. But because you're used to having the club on the ground most of the time, to have it hover up is very strange. So you want to be really extended, but you want to have it right at the equator of the ball, and you got to go forward and you got to hit the ground like always. Mm. See, when you're in the fairway bunker is not the time to learn that. You want to learn that when you're hitting regular full shots. And really, it's good for you to do. Hover it as close as you can to the ball. So watch, if you were doing this on the range and you had the club against the ball here, you would just put it up to there, but you know, close enough so you wouldn't hit the ball, but really a half an inch, but at the equator, no closer than that.
Yep.
People who hit here hit the sand first, so you keep it up here, you'll stretch out and you'll hit ball first. So make sure you go forward and hit down. Mm-hmm. Once you're doing that well on the range, then you have a real chance to do it when you're in the bunker.
Perfect.
Great job, buddy. You got a couple of them out of there pretty well.
Not bad. Lucky.
There may be hope for you.
All right, so that's a wrap for this lesson and the session. Hopefully it's been helpful for you. I didn't even realize you could do all that in the bunker, and I'm hoping I'm no longer ever gonna be stuck in that bunker again. And so definitely drop that like. Every single like that you provide actually helps so much because we're a small channel. Hopefully you guys stay tuned, follow this journey, subscribe, and I hopefully will see you guys tomorrow. Peace.